things that I think we need to do to ensure that. One is making sure that developers like Alexander Kogan, who got access to a lot of information and then improperly used it, just don't get access to as much information going forward. So we are doing a set of things to restrict the amount of access that developers can get going forward. But the other is we need to make sure that there aren't any other Cambridge Analytica's out there, right, or folks who have improperly accessed data. So we're going to go now and investigate every app that has access to a large amount of information from before we lock down our platform. And if we detect any suspicious activity, we're going to do a full forensic audit.
Facebook has asked us to share our data, to share our lives on this platform, and has wanted us to be transparent. And people don't feel like they've received that same amount of transparency. They're wondering what's happening to their data. Can they trust Facebook?
Yeah, so one of the most important things that I think we need to do here is make sure that we tell everyone whose data was affected by one of these roadmaps, right? And we're going to do that. We're going to build a tool where anyone can go and see if their data was a part of this.
But so the 50 million people that were impacted, they will be able to tell if they were impacted by this.
We're going to be even conservative on that. So, you know, we might not have all the data in our system today. So anyone whose data might have been affected by this, we're gonna make sure that we tell. And going forward, when we identify apps that are similarly doing sketchy things, we're going to make sure that we tell people then too, right? That's definitely something that, you know, looking back on this, I regret that we didn't do at the time. And I think we got that wrong, and we're committed to getting that right going forward.
I want to ask about that, because when this came to light, you guys knew this a long time ago, that this data was out there. Why didn't you tell users? Don't you think users have the right to know that their data is being used for different purposes?
So, yes. And let me tell you what actions we took. So in 2015, some journalists from The Guardian told us that they had seen or had some evidence that data that this app developer, Alexander Kogan, who built this personality quiz app and a bunch of people used it and shared data with it, had sold that data to Cambridge Analytica and a few other firms. And when we heard that, and that's against the policies, right? I mean, you can't share data in a way that people don't know or don't consent to. We immediately banned Kogan's app. And further, we made it so that Kogan and Cambridge Analytica and the other folks with whom we shared the data, we asked for a formal certification that they had none of the data from anyone in the Facebook community, that they deleted it if they had it, and that they weren't using it. And they all provided that certification. So as far as we understood around the time of that episode, there was no data out there.
So why didn't Facebook follow up? You know, you say you certified it. I think, why wasn't there more of a follow-up? Why wasn't there an audit then? Why does it take a big media report to get that proactive approach?
Well, I mean, I don't know about you, but I'm used to when people legally certify that they're going to do something, that they do it. But I think that this was clearly a mistake in retrospect.
Was it putting too much trust in developers?
I think it did. And that's why, you know, we need to make sure that we don't make that mistake ever again, which is why one of the things that I announced today is that we're going to do a full investigation into every app that had access to a large amount of data from around this time before we locked down the platform. And we're now not just going to take people's word for it and when they give us a legal certification, but if we see anything suspicious, which I think that there probably were signs in this case that we could have looked into, we're going to do a full forensic audit.
How do you know there aren't hundreds more companies like Cambridge Analytica that are also keeping data that violates Facebook's policies?
Well, I think the question here is, do our app developers who people have given access to their data, are they doing something that people don't want? Are they selling the data in a way that people don't want? Are they giving it to someone that they don't have authorization to do? And this is something that I think we now need to go figure out, right? So for all these apps,
that's going to be a really challenging ordeal. How do you actually go do that? Because you talk about it being years ago, and then you guys have made it a bit stricter for that kind of information to be shared. But backtracking on it, it's going to be really difficult to find out where that data has gone and what other companies have shady access.
Yeah, I mean, so as you say, I mean, the good news here is.